Hello viewers, here in front of you, H.M. Kalita, Senior Faculty Member of Equilibrium Residential IS Coaching Academy, Guwahati. Today, we are going to discuss a topic from Assam history. The topic is Civil Disobedience Movement in Assam. We are going to discuss the Civil Disobedience Movement of 1930 to 1933-34 and Assam's participation in that civil disobedience movement. So, let us start the topic. As you know, in November 1927, the British government appointed a commission under the leadership of Sir John Simon. British government appointed a commission under the chairmanship of Sir John Simon to inquire the working of the Montfort reforms. The commission, normally known as the Simon Commission, in order to inquire the performance, the working of the Montego Chelmsford reform of 1919. But the commission not including any Indian, the commission didn't include any Indian, and that is why that created white resentment in the country. As a result, Congress decided to boycott the commission. In spite of the protest made by the Congress, the commission visited India in February 1928 and submitted its recommendation. Government adamant, though it was opposed, the Congress protested as there was no representative from India. But British government, in spite of the protest made by the Congress, the Simon Commission visited India in February 1928 and submitted its recommendation. As a result, Congress then agreed to accept dominion status if granted on or before 31st December 1931. Congress now adamant. Congress adamant, and they agreed to accept dominion status and that to be granted on or before 31st December 1931. On Congress adamant of asking for dominion status, then British government replied that the matter would be taken up in the light of the recommendation of Simon Commission in a roundtable conference of different parties to be held at London. Congress government, they agreed to accept dominion status, and in reply of Congress, British government replied that the matter would be taken up in light of the recommendation of Simon Commission in a roundtable conference of all parties that will be held in London. But the Congress refused to participate in the roundtable conference unless India was promised a full dominion status. Now Congress adamant. They want the promise from the British government that unless India was promised a full dominion status, Congress was not to attend the roundtable conference. Then came the Lahore session. In the Lahore session held in December 1929, Lahore session was held in December 1929. And INC, Indian National Congress, therefore declared that complete independence as its goal. In the Lahore session of 1929, Indian National Congress therefore declared complete independence as its goal and resolved to boycott the legislatures, boycott roundtable conference, and took steps to launch a new program, that is civil disobedience movement. Now, Congress took resolution. They passed resolution in Lahore session in December 1929. According to those resolutions, INC declared complete independence as its goal and resolved to boycott all legislatures, boycott roundtable conference, and they are going to launch a new program, that is civil disobedience movement. Accordingly, January 26, 1930, Independence Day was observed all over the country by INC members. And this event, this January 26 event, became a regular annual practice since then till final independence was achieved in 1947. So 1930, 26 January was the first Independence Day observed throughout the country. And then it became a regular annual practice. And every 26 January since 1930, January 26 was observed as the Independence Day after 1930 till final independence was achieved in 1947. Although the decision of the Lahore Congress session was received by the leaders of APCC with mixed feelings in Assam. Those leaders of APCC, they took those decisions of Lahore with mixed feelings. But first Independence Day was observed with great enthusiasm in the province. But there appeared a difference of opinion regarding Assam's joining the civil disobedience movement. Veteran Congress leaders like Torun Ramphukon, Gopinath Bordoloi, Rohini Kumar Chaudhary holding the view that Assam was not ready to join the civil disobedience movement at this time. Those veteran leaders like Gopinath Bordoloi, Torun Ramphukon, Rohini Kumar Chaudhary, they are of the view that Assam was not yet ready to join, to launch another movement. And they resigned from their offices in the provincial congress. Those leaders, Torun Ramphukon, Gopinath Bordoloi, Rohini Kumar Chaudhary, they all resigned from the offices of the provincial congress. The crisis, however, was successfully evaded when Bishnuram Medhi, a young Congress leader, came forward to accept the responsible office of president of APCC. Once those veteran leaders resigned from the APCC, Bishnuram Medhi, a new and a young Congress leader, who came forward to accept the office of that responsible office of president of APCC. Of course, Bishnuram Medhi was supported. He got the help from Muhammad Toibullah, the then GS of APCC, along with Toibullah, Siddhinath Horma, Hemchandra Borua, Ambigagi Rai Chaudhury, and Amiyo Kumar Das also supported Bishnuram Medhi, and they all conducted the movement with fresh enthusiasm. Now, new leaders, Bishnuram Medhi, under his leadership, along with Muhammad Toibullah, Amiyo Kumar Das, Siddhinath Horma, Hemchandra Borua, Ambigagi Rai Chaudhury, they took the initiative and they conducted the movement with fresh enthusiasm. By the time Mahatma Gandhi started the civil disobedience campaign by his famous Mars, Dandi Mars, to his Mars to Dandi, beginning on March 12, 1933, to make salt in defiance of the salt law regulation. Mahatma Gandhi, on 12 March 1930, left Sabarmati Ashram of Ahmedabad on foot, along with 78 other members of the ashram, for Dandi, a village on western sea coast of India, at a distance about 385 kilometers from Ahmedabad. Mahatma Gandhi started his Dandi Mars from Sabarmati Ashram to Dandi, a village in western sea coast. The distance between Dandi and Sabarmati Ashram is around 385 kilometers. The Mahatma Gandhi, along with those 78 supporters, they start the marathon march, and they reached Dandi on 6th April 1930. They took around 24 to 25 days to reach those 385 kilometers on foot. And there at Dandi, Mahatma Gandhi broke the salt law. In Assam also, the Assam Congress was also ready to launch the mass civil disobedience movement in the province. Soon, the news of arrest of national leaders like Gandhiji and Jawaharlal Nehru now reached Assam. When Gandhiji broke the salt law, he was arrested. Jawaharlal Nehru was arrested. The news of their arrest came to Assam. The arrest of Nehru was followed by hartal by school children in various places. And that hartal started on April 14, 1930. With the arrest and imprisonment of Gandhiji, it was further intensified the civil disobedience movement in Assam. The authorities then clamped Section 144 in Nogaon, Tezpur, Dhubri, and other places to suppress the spontaneous reactions of the people. Now, authorities let loose those repressive measures like Section 144 promulgated in places like Nogaon, Tezpur, Dhubri, and other places in order to suppress those spontaneous reactions of the people. But people everywhere violated Section 144 and organized processions and meetings. People are now violating those Section 144 and organized processions and meetings. Students were actively participating in the movement, and in one of such cases, they had to suffer indiscriminate lathi charge, which brought about severe injury of 20 students. Students were actively participating in the movement, and in such a movement, police lathi charge over the student, and on that lathi charge, there was a severe injury to 20 students. Even in Surma Valley, there was a quick and warm response to the civil disobedience movement. There in Surma Valley, there are several cases of violation of salt law regulation in the Surma Valley. And they also took Mars to Noakhali to make salt in the indigenous way out of saline water from the Bay of Bengal. Those people in the Surma Valley, they also broke the salt law by making indigenous salt out of the saline water of Bay of Bengal. The active role of students of both the valley, that means both valley of Surma Valley and Brahmaputra Valley, compelled the government to instruct principals of MC College and Cotton College to inform students that their active participation in the political agitation in future would disqualify them for getting any government jobs, any government appointment. Now, government authority they let loose the repressive measure, and the authority then they gave order to the principal of MC College and Cotton College, and they informed the students that they, if they participate in the political agitation, then in future they would not be, I mean, they will not be eligible to get a government appointment, government jobs. Notwithstanding those warnings, the students of MC College not only observed a hurtal on April 15, protesting the arrest of Nehru, but also boycotted the college. Those students of MC Colleges, they not only they go for the hurtal, they even boycott the college. At this boycott of college, the principal D.E. Roberts, the principal of MC College, expelled around 26 student leaders. Civil disobedience movement greatly warmed the government. The civil disobedience movement greatly alarmed the authority. To deter those students from playing any active role in politics, Mr. J. A. Cunningham, the then DPI of Assam province, promulgated a circular to all academic heads of the province. The most popular Cunningham circle, promulgated by then DPI of Assam province, Mr. J. A. Cunningham. And he promulgated the circular, the Cunningham circular, to the all academic heads of the province. This circular required the students as well as their parents and guardians. The circular required the students as well as the parents and guardians to give an undertaking in writing that students would refrain from participating in any kind of political activities and abide by the disciplinary rules and orders of the institution head and education department. According to Cunningham Circle, according to this Cunningham circular, the students of the valley, along with their parents and guardians, have to give in writing and undertaking that they are not going to take part any of these political activity, they are not going to join any of these, participate any kind of political activities, and they would abide by the rules and disciplinary rules and regulation of the institution head and education department. On 12 November 1930, the opening day of the first round table conference at London, when 58 Indian delegates representing all parties, including liberals, Hindu, communalist, and Muslim League. The first roundtable conference was attended by 58 Indian delegates representing parties like Liberal, Hindu, Communalist, and Muslim League. But the Congress sat together along with 16 others from the Indian princely state. They had not, the Congress and those 16 members from the princely state, they had not joined the roundtable conference. Looking at this scenario, demonstration led by Congress workers in all over the Assam province of Assam in defiance of the prohibitive order of the authority. Looking at those scenario of at London, the roundtable conference was held at first roundtable conference held at London, and it was on 12 November 1930. Only 58 members from Indian delegates, that's the representing the parties like Liberal, Hindu, Communist, and Muslim League. Congress and 16 others from the Indian princely states, they have not joined. And looking at those scenario, demonstration led by Congress workers all over the province of Assam in defense of the prohibitory orders. Guneshwari Devi and Mukteshwari Devi of Nogaon were the first Indian in the first ladies in the province of Assam to be imprisoned in the course of national struggle. The first lady, those detained, those imprisoned were Guneshwari Devi and Mukteswari Devi for joining the national struggle, that is the civil disobedience movement. Among the women leaders arrested in different parts of the province, Chandraprabha Hoikiani, the leader of the women picketers at Guwahati, and Girija Bala Gupta, who had been organizing the women folk at Karimganj, were also prominent. Those were also arrested. In spite of the numerous arrests and imprisonment, the movement gained increasingly greater day by day. Day by day, the civil disobedience movement gained momentum. The office of the president of APCC, the office of the president of APCC remained vacant for some time after Vishnuram Medhi's arrest in August 1930. As Vishnuram Medhi was arrested, the office of the president of APCC remained vacant. But later on, it was filled by Jadav Prasad Solihan. Meanwhile, the Assam visit of Lord Irwin, the Viceroy, the Lord Irwin was the Viceroy, his visit was marked by demonstration organized at Jorhat under the leadership of Deveshwar Horma. Just a year after, Gandhiji, who disclaimed underground activities as being against the Congress policy and assured the landlord not to be frightened by Congress Soras. According to Gandhi, those underground activity not the policy of the Congress. And he has assured those landlord not to be frightened by those Congress Soras. And in this scenario, Mahatma Gandhi suspended after conducting a pact with Irwin on March 4, 1931. All of a sudden, Mahatma Gandhi concluded a pact with Lord Irwin, the Viceroy. And this is called the Irwin Pact. And the Irwin Pact was signed between Lord Irwin, the Viceroy, and Mahatma Gandhi on March 4, 1931. This Irwin Pact left the vital question of India's independence totally. This Irwin Pact left virtual the question of India's independence untouched. Indian independence was not touched in this Irwin Pact, not even the provision of dominion status also touched. In this Irwin Pact, they have not discussed anything about India's independence. Even there was no provision for dominion status for India. Yet, committed the Congress to participate the Round Table Conference. In this act, Gandhiji committed that Congress would participate in the Round Table Conference and government to release only those civil disobedience prisoners who were not committed to any charge of violence. All of a sudden, like in non-cooperation movement, Mahatma Gandhi single-handedly suspended the non-cooperation after the Chaurisaura incidents. Here also, Mahatma Gandhi, after signing the Irwin Pact on 4th March 1931, he suspended the first phase of civil disobedience movement. And thus, Irwin Pact left the vital question of India's independence untouched, even the provision for dominion status also not discussed. Only Congress committed to participate in the roundtable conference, the second roundtable conference, and government to release those detainees of civil disobedience detainees, those don't have any criminal, any charge of violence. Nehru and Patel expressed their shock at the signing of Irwin Pact. So did many other freedom leaders freedom fighters also shocked at the signing of Iron Pact. And Gandhiji, the sole Congress member attending the second round table conference, realized that he made a mistake. Gandhiji, representing Congress in the second round table conference, he realized the mistake that he made by signing the Iron Pact, because that Iron Pact, Indian independence was untouched, even the dominion status was not discussed. It was only the release of those detainees, those don't have any violence charge. Unable to take a clear stand there in the second round table conference, Gandhiji only reiterated the claim for the Congress being the sole representative of all classes and all people of India, and he left the conference. In the round table conference, Gandhiji only reiterated that Congress the sole representative of all classes and all people. And by saying those words, he left the conference. This all about your first phase of civil disobedience movement. Started in 12 March 1930, and it was suspended from signing of Iron Pact. The Iron Pact was signed on 4th March 1931. You may ask me, who are the leaders that took part in the first phase of civil disobedience movement? From the leaders of the civil disobedience movement, we can talk about Guneshwari Devi, we can talk about Mukteshwari Devi of Nogaon, Chandraprabha Hoikani of Guwahati, and Girijabala Gupta of Karimgarh. Among the other leaders, Tarun Ram Phukan, our Bordoloi, Gopinath Bordoloi, Rohini Kumar Chaudhary, Vishnuram Medhi, Mohammad Toibula, Ambikagiri Rai Chaudhary, Omiya Kumar Das, Hemchandra Burua, those are the some of the leaders of civil disobedience movement. Now we are going to discuss the second phase of civil disobedience movement. As you know, the second Roundtable Conference at London was vitiated. The second Roundtable Conference in London was vitiated by the raising of the communal problems, which was made all the more complicated by pressing demand of the representatives of the Hindu untouchable, and that too by Dr. Ambedkar, for a separate electorate for those untouchable as well. The second roundtable conference, it was vitiated by the rage of the communal problems, which was made all the more complicated by pressing demand of the representative of the Hindu untouchable, even by Dr. Ambedkar, a separate electorate for them. It was followed by declaration of the notorious communal award by Sir Ramsay MacDonald, the then British PM. The then British PM, Sir Ramsay MacDonald, has declared the notorious communal award to India. Further, Gandhiji, on his return to India from the London, the second roundtable conference, found the government letting loose its repressive measures, and Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Khan Bahadur Khan were detained and they are put behind the bars. Now authorities let loosing the repressive measures, and they have detained Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru and Khan Bahadur Khan, and they are put behind the bars. Circumstances now forced the Working Committee of the Congress to decide on January 1st, 1932, to resume civil disobedience movement, that is the second phase of this civil disobedience movement, was about to start from January 1st, 1932. Looking at those repressive measures, the Working Committee of the Congress, they have taken a decision on January 1st, 1932 to resume the second phase of civil disobedience movement. It was taken the decision on 1st January 1932. 3 days later, that is on 4th, 5th, the government arrested Gandhiji and declared Congress illegal. Now, Gandhiji, coming back to India from London, he was also arrested. After, that is on 4th January 1932, Gandhiji was arrested and declared Congress as illegal and issued a number of new repressive measures. Now, authorities have issued a number of repressive measures also. In Assam too, as elsewhere, congressmen defied these measures and the government responded to it with even greater cruelty. In Assam also, the congressmen defied those measures, those repressive measures, and government responded to it with even greater cruelty. A large number of men and women were arrested. Even many like Navin Chandra Borloi, who kept themselves aloof during the first phase of civil disobedience movement, now failed to resist and were thrown into the jail. According to official sources, altogether 1,494 persons were arrested up to 31st March 1932, and of them, 1,076 persons, including 80 women, were convicted till mid-August. Around, out of this 1,076, 80 women, they were all convicted. They are convicted by till mid-August. Prominent among those leaders, those convicted leaders were convicted and imprisoned. Those prominent leaders were Chandra Prabha Hoikiani, Hem Chandra Borua, Purna Chandra Horma, Gohan Chandra Goswami, Vijay Chandra Bhagavati, Mahendra Mohan Chaudhary, B. N. Chaudhary, B.P. Chaliha, Sudhanshu Banerjee, and young leaders like Jyoti Prakash Agarwal, Hemanga Biswas, and Dhiren Chandra Datta. These are the leaders convicted and arrested. The movement, the civil disobedience movement, had its repercussion even in the hills of province of Assam. Inspired by the teaching of Mahatma Gandhi, the Naga Queen Gaidalu and her followers dreamed of freedom for her people, raised the banner of independence and called her people to rally round it. As the orders of the political agents of Manipur, Gaidalu was captured and put in the Imphal jail and sentenced to transportation for life in January 1933. Gaidalu sent for life imprisonment in January 1933. Following mass arrest and confinement of the national leaders and leading organizations all over the country, now the government felt free to implement constitutional proposals. The establishment of a separate electorate for the depressed classes as per the communal award of the new schemes. Now, government declared separate communal electorate for the depressed classes. on this establishment of separate electorate for the depressed classes, Gandhiji was provoked. The provoked Gandhiji then in jail. To protest against it, Gandhiji undertook a fast unto death. In jail, Gandhiji undertook fast unto death. Gandhiji was then negotiated. After a period of prolonged negotiation, Gandhiji agreed to the Pune Pact. Gandhiji, against those separate electorate for depressed classes, Gandhiji went for first unto death in the jail. Gandhiji was negotiated for a prolonged period of negotiation was there with Gandhiji, and Gandhiji agreed to the Pune Pact. And the Pune Pact was signed in September 24, 1932. And according to this Pune Pact, Gandhiji accepted the joint electorate but settled the bargain with Dr. Ambedkar by getting the number of seats reserved for the depressed classes. He made it doubled instead of the proposed separate electorate. According to Pune Pact, there was no separate electorate but a joint electorate. And Gandhiji bargained with Ambedkar by getting the number of seats for the reserved for the depressed classes. Those numbers were doubled. Gandhiji again temporarily suspended the mass civil disobedience movement after his release from the jail in May 1933. Meanwhile, the Congress decided once again to fight the reforms from within by contesting the election. This all about the civil disobedience movement. Now we have talked about the civil disobedience movement. The civil disobedience movement started on 12 March 1930 by Dandi March, and the first phase was suspended after the signing of Iron Pact, that is on 4th March 1931. Then again, second phase of civil disobedience movement started by January 1st, 1932. Again, the second phase of civil disobedience movement temporarily suspended by signing the Pune Pact. That Pune Pact was signed on 24th September 1932. But Congress officially suspended the civil disobedience movement in May 1933 after Gandhiji's release from the jail, and Congress withdrew the civil disobedience movement in May 1934. Now the ban on Assam Congress also lifted on June 13, 1934, and the election to the Indian Legislative Assembly was held in November of 1934. In the election held in November 1934, Nabin Chandra Bordoloi secured a sweeping victory over Torun Ram Phukan, a member of the Congress Nationalist Party. Torun Ram Phukan had been a member of the Central Legislature since 1923 till November 1934, a long period. Soon, Nabin Chandra Bordoloi distinguishing himself as an influential member of the Assembly. But Nabin Chandra Bordoloi's career cut short by his death on 1936. The other congressmen to be elected in the Central Legislature were B.K. Das from the Surma Valley, and Muslim seat was owned by Abdul Mateen Chowdhury through by Muslim League ticket. This all about civil disobedience movement launched by Congress under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi that started in 12 March 1930. And first phase was suspended after signing of Iron Pact in 4th March 1931. Again started second phase 1st January 1932. Again it was suspended by signing of Pune Pact on 24th September 1932. And Congress officially suspended civil disobedience movement in May 1933 and withdrew civil disobedience movement in May 1934. Now, the third roundtable conference held at the close of 1932. The third roundtable conference also attended by small number of representatives from India. Drafted its proposal for reform of the Indian Constitution, and it was published in March 1933. A bill was prepared on the basis of the third roundtable conference and with slight alteration, and finally this bill became the Government of India Act 1935. So we are going to discuss in the next topic about Government of India Act 1935 and about the Sadula Ministry and about the Gopinath Bordoloi Ministry. So this is all about civil disobedience movement launched by Indian National Congress under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi and Assam's participation in it. I hope you understand, you enjoy the discussion. Thank you.